Van life originally was all about minimizing what you had and traveling the world on a budget. It was all about minimizing overconsumption and trying to find a way to travel and focus more on the traveling part, not necessarily on the luxury part. But in recent years, that tune has certainly seemed to change. And today, I really want to talk to you about van life, how it's changed and how it hasn't been for the better. My name's Tash and I'm a part-time van lifer here in Australia. And honestly, van life isn't a new thing. It has been around for decades and even longer than that. Van life as we know it today only really started to become popular in the last 10, 20 years, more so the last 10 years, especially with the gentrification. But before that, people were using vans just like this one. And even before that, the Romani people were traveling all throughout their lives and still do. So van life is not a new concept at all. But I think it's interesting to see the progression that we've seen just recently as to what van life looks like now. These days, when you look at van life online, it certainly seems like it's full of luxury sprinter vans and people teaching you how to build out those vans. But there really isn't all that much about the middle ground, which is where people usually start. I know for myself, I really didn't feel like this van was enough when I first started van life. I felt like I had to sell it to get a sprinter and then spend 20 grand to make it look like a little condo on wheels. And that's crazy. Like, it's a van. Like, that's all you need for van life. And most people do even less. Like, they can do it in a car as well. But the thing that we get marketed most commonly on social media are these beautiful vans, but they don't exactly cost an affordable price. I know for myself, I didn't have the cash flow for even getting a sprinter. And there's a reason why this space kind of looks like still a van. It's because I couldn't afford to do it. But I really wanted to get out there, so I didn't really care all that much about what my van looked like. And I think ever since this gentrification of van life, where it's only getting bigger and better, you really do feel inadequate when you have something smaller or something that doesn't look like the Pinterest board that you've created. And I think people have forgotten, myself included, that van life can sometimes be the last resort before someone becomes homeless. I really didn't realize this until I was doing my more recent stint when I was really struggling a bit mentally with having to try and find certain things every day. Finding water, finding a bathroom, finding electricity was a big one for me. And it was so hard to find it in public settings. Like, if it wasn't for the fact that I had a gym membership, it would have made my life so much worse. Especially with the cost of living crisis at the moment, I think people have forgotten that van life is sometimes a last resort for a lot of people, and that hasn't gone away. Like, just because of this gentrification of van life doesn't mean that it isn't a last resort for some people. And when you're traveling like myself, it can certainly look like that it's a last resort for me, but I've got the support networks and backups that this is a chosen choice. This isn't always a choice for people. And I think we're forgetting that, especially when you look at social media. So I guess that begs the question, is van life gentrifying or glorifying homelessness? And I believe to some degree it is. Like, obviously, the whole point of van life is to show off the travels, show off the fact that you can travel by car to so many amazing different places. But when you look on social media, it's all about decking out this van or that, and what else can you put into a small van like this? And it's much less about where you are, and it's much less about the traveling aspect. So I do think van life has unfortunately gentrified and glorified some aspects of homelessness. I know when I was really struggling during my last stint, I was really feeling like I couldn't be anywhere in public. Like, I would be there cooking some food at one of the public barbecues, and I would feel this immense feeling that I wasn't wanted there. And it wasn't like I had any bad experiences. Everyone was lovely to me. Sometimes I get a weird look or two because I'd be in pajamas, and that's on me. But I had this feeling inside of me that I wasn't allowed. And obviously, with van life, it is a bit different to homelessness. Obviously, I'm choosing to be in those spaces. I'm choosing to travel. But even when you're traveling on a budget, you can start to feel on some honest level, very similar to someone that is homeless. You don't feel like you're safe. You don't feel like you're allowed anywhere. When you are trying to enjoy a place, you kind of feel like you have to move on quite quickly. Obviously, when you're traveling as a solo female like myself, you're always hyper aware about who's following you, whether or not you're in a safe space or not, where you're going to park for the night. Like, you can't just park up anywhere. And there's always that innate little fear that, like, the cops are going to come or someone's going to be banging on your door in the middle of the night. And, you know, I think I'm really struggling to articulate this because I really feel for people that are truly homeless and who have experienced homelessness. And I don't want to be the one gentrifying or saying, look how great my life is and all of that. Like, I don't want to, like, almost put those people's feelings and experiences in such a lighthearted note, because it is a terrible thing to be homeless. I can see how much privilege that I have with my ability to travel and my ability to just go and save just a couple hundred dollars and be able to just travel wherever I want to go. Like, if I had any form of dependence or any other responsibilities, that would not be the case for me. That wouldn't be the case for a lot of people either. Anyway, I just wanted to kind of talk about van life and some of the negative aspects of it, because as much as I do love to look at, like, van builds and stuff, like, obviously that is a little bit of a pastime of mine, I think it's something that we need to keep in mind that sometimes this isn't a choice for some people. And, you know, we are so privileged to be able to travel this way, but because of van lifers traveling, it is making stuff harder for people who are homeless or on the brink of homelessness. Obviously, more and more parking signs are coming up saying no overnight parking. So people who are actually struggling can't find places to stay at night. And that really saddens me. Like, I wish that there wasn't such thing as brutalist architecture. When I was learning about interior design, I was mortified by the fact that we had created that for getting people to move on and not providing a safe space for someone to sleep. And yeah, I think the other thing that I kind of just want to highlight to people is that van life isn't like what it seems online. Obviously, I've discussed this a little bit already, but, you know, you're not always parked up on a beautiful beach drinking a matcha latte and having a border collie, like, go run about and stuff. A lot of the time it is in parking lots. It is in streets and trying to stealth camp and hope no one catches you. And obviously, I've never been homeless. I've been very, very fortunate in that sense. And I'm not trying to put words into their mouths or anyone that has been homeless. But I think when you're doing low budget van life, especially like this, you can certainly have this deep appreciation for the fact that you at least have some roof over your head. Like, I'm honestly so grateful just to have this roof over my head, let alone the roof that I have in my own home. And luxury van lifers don't really show that to you. They show you that they're always parked up on a beautiful beach every single day. They've got their matcha latte in hand and their border collie out running and about. And it's just not the case. And I would really love to see van life go a bit back to what it originally was. And obviously, I don't mean all the way back to the Romani people, but I do mean, you know, using what you have and just going out and traveling. Like, I really do wish that more and more people would just take up the opportunity to go. And I would love to see more and more van builds where it's a lower cost budget and people have just, like, thrown things together like myself. Because I think if we made this change, a lot more people would be able to do it, would want to do it, and there would be a much more diverse crowd of people that are doing it, not just people that are extremely well off or have saved for a very long period of time and have these completely decked out vans. I know that part of the reason I do these van life videos is for that explicit reason. Like, I want to show you and inspire you that you don't need the Sprinter. You don't need to have these massive van builds. Like, sometimes all you need is a mattress in the back and just go. Obviously, this isn't for long-term van life, but, you know, a lot of the time van life isn't long-term anyway, so you might as well just get out there. Especially with people in my own generation, I do feel like van life and tiny houses have been a huge impact on us because with the housing crises, a lot of us feel like we are never going to be able to own a home, and this was an alternative way to live. And I think it's a little bit sad because I wouldn't want van life to be my forever thing. I've never wanted it to be my forever thing. And the fact that a lot of us feel like we're never going to be able to own a home is just upsetting. Like, I want van life to be chosen, not because you feel like you can't own a home, but because you want to travel in that way, not necessarily because of any other reason. And yeah, I just want to make that note. Anyway, I kind of just wanted to talk about van life just for a bit because I feel like it's just changed to the point where people feel like it's not attainable anymore. And I would love for it to go back to this cheap travel way of doing things, you know, even if people are camping up a campsite, so then it allows people that are truly homeless or on the brink of such poverty that it allows them to be able to continue stealth camping and stuff. And I think I want to kind of make that change and be a little bit more intentional with the directions I head off into. Like, I don't really want to be camping in the suburbs or anything like that. I'd much rather be a bit further out and in nature, which is all van life was intended to be, especially when you're not doing it out of necessity. Yeah, I just really wanted to talk about this a little bit today because I had been thinking about this topic a little bit, and I just really wanted to bring it to light and kind of have my own little discussion about it. So I'd love to hear what you guys have thought about it, and if you've experienced homelessness or something similar, whether or not you feel like van life has gentrified some of your struggles. Like, I would love to hear what your thoughts are down below. Before we go, I'm going to quickly show you where we are. I am going to be one of those cheeky YouTubers and not tell you exactly where I am because this is my secret location. No one else knows where it is. But the place here is just absolutely stunning, and I feel just very grateful to be alive. Whether or not van life has been fully gentrified and is glorifying homelessness, it's up to personal opinion, and everyone's situations are different. Like, I know that I am extremely grateful for the fact that I don't have any dependents and I can just save a little money and just go. But I know it's an extremely different case for anybody else. So I'd love to hear your guys' thoughts down below. Let me know what you think. What do you think about van life in this context? Do you think that we've glorified it to the point where it's only a rich person's thing? Or do you think it's still something that is actually truly affordable and is a great way of travel? Let me know in the comments below, guys, and I will see you on our next adventure.